Good. A little bit high.
I am a little bit.
Yeah, you need to be a little deeper, but it's all, your stance is a little too close, but that's not what I'm saying. Widen your stance a little bit. Point your toes out a little more. And let your knees track out with your toes. Shove your knees out. Yeah, but you're not really using your hips, and that's the whole problem.
But now, I want you to notice what your back angle is. So your back angle is more horizontal now than you had a second ago. Okay? You keep thinking, raise the chest. You keep lifting the chest up out of the bottom of the squat. And lifting the chest instead of driving your hips. Now look, now stay at the bottom. Now look, this is how you squat. Drive up against my knee. Push up hard. Real hard. That's how you squat. Do that again. Drive your ass up out of the bottom, see? That's how hip drive is initiated, okay? And your back has to, your back angle has to accommodate the position of the bar on your back in order that that hip drive take place. If you keep lifting your chest up, in other words, come up about two-thirds of the way, right here, like about right there, it's about halfway up. Now, if right here, instead of driving, continuing to drive that on up, you do this instead. You lift your chest up. See what happened to your knees? Do it again. Pay attention what happens to your knees when you do that. See them come forward?
Yeah.
If they go forward, you're taking tension off your hamstrings. At the minute, when the hamstrings are supposed to be helping you pull this end of their attachment up, you're shortening them from the knee end. See? And if you do that, then you're killing your hamstring tension. You're fixing it so that they can't continue that drive at this end of their insertion. Okay? Hamstring's got two ends, right? Hamstring's got a knee end and a hip end. We're trying to use them from the hip end, the proximal end. And if you shorten them from the knee end, then you take the tension off of them at a time when that tension is being used to make the hip end extend. Okay? When you lift your chest out of the bottom of the squat, instead of drive your butt, you're setting yourself into a position, setting up a position where you can't really drive your hips. Okay? So, get under this bar again. Same thing. And I want you to not think about lifting the chest, but I want you to think about shoving that up. Okay? Let's see.
Should my back be a certain incline?
Don't worry about that. You just worry about driving that up the whole time. Okay, let's see. Elbows up, keep your elbows up. Keep your chest up, but look down. Because that's going to enable the hip drive to take place. Elbows up, now drive your ass. Like that, good, again. I want you to look down there, okay? Big breath, big breath. Drive your ass up, just drive your ass up. Now, don't drive your ass up at the expense of not standing up. Finish standing up. Finish standing up. Two more. Drive it. Okay. Now, that's a little exaggerated, but that's what's got to happen. Now, balance. That looks better. Again, drive. Drive your ass. Good. Now, not so much kick. Just make a nice, smooth squat, but lead with your butt. A good, now get deep, and you got it. Now, that looks pretty good. Now finish standing up. Good. One more. One more punishment for high. Get out deep. Drive your butt. Pretty good, right? See how that's a little better? High hold. That's good depth there. But you need to have a tiny bit wider stance from the individual. Like that. That's good. Stay in the middle of your foot. Get it deep. Shove your ass in. Excellent. Four. Good.